Dude, the sun's being a fucking asshole. What movements were those? He spun once and then went? Like, when does he do that? We're going into runs without any practice. Yeah, I can guarantee, if you're good enough to pull off like midairs and like play super hard Mario Maker levels, I mean, you're good enough to do things in Mario 3. Just the physics is gonna be different, so. Your timings for everything is gonna be completely off, sadly. But that's not even your fault, so celebrate. Sadly, there's nowhere that that P-Wing can save me enough time where I can justify wasting like the 7 seconds in the mushroom house. It's a mushroom house, right? Like, why would I ever time a mushroom house? You never go into mushroom house in any speedrun, so we would never really officially time it. But I have timed it before, and if I were to remember correctly, it's like six to like 8 seconds, I think, for a mushroom house. So the P-Wing that I get from the mushroom house would have to save at least that time back, and even if that was the case, what, it wouldn't be worth it, right? So it'd have to save me, like, at least a little bit of time. Oh, I ducked. I'm not ducking anymore. That P-Speed strat out of the pipe makes no sense to you? Which P-Speed strat? Oh, it's because I had P-Speed when I entered up into the pipe, right? So once I jumped up into the pipe, doing a pipe transition, the game doesn't actually register Mario as being on the ground. I'm still in the air while I'm transitioning through the pipe. So whenever I come into the pipe, Mario stands on the ground for like a couple frames and I hold forward a little bit. And by holding forward a little bit, it allows me to just kind of like recharge the P-Speed a little bit without it dissipating, I guess. It's really hard to explain. The pipe transitions with keeping P-Speed is a very feel-like understanding, if that makes sense. You really have to feel it to really understand it. You gotta play around with the P-Meter to understand. You can't just look at the P-Meter and understand it. It'll never work. You have to play the game and, like, do P-Speed strats to really understand how the P-Meter works. Keeping P-Speed through pipe transitions is not difficult at all. It's literally holding forward and pressing A once you transition. As long as you don't touch the pipe when you enter the pipe, which is going to be the complicated part for you guys to understand, you cannot touch the pipe when you enter the pipe. The first frame that you touch the pipe has to be the same frame that you enter the pipe. If you run along the pipe, then enter, like if you run a bit on the pipe and then enter, you'll lose your P-Speed because you ran on the ground first, right? See, watch, I'm gonna do it right here. I'm not gonna touch the pipe. The first frame I touched it, I enter the pipe, so now I'm gonna move forward a bit and then jump. Then I kept it. Up pipes are the easiest to keep your P-Speed because it's impossible for you to actually run across an upward pipe since you're rubbing your head on it, and rubbing your head isn't your feet, so. Dude, what a fucking piece, man. There's 6 spaces for him to move back there, and he has to move in the only one space that causes me time. You gotta be kidding me. I hate you, Hammer Brother. Why do I even expect them to cooperate? I shouldn't expect them to cooperate. Anything RNG related, I should just be like, yeah, I expect that. I'm actually going into this run right now, expecting just to get the worst RNG possible. That run failed because of RNG. Son of a bitch. It's only natural though. The sun is an extremely angry enemy. Angrier more than most. Most enemies in this game don't really have much of a facial expression, but the creators decided that the sun needed a facial expression and it had to be angry. I wonder what everyone's childhood would have been like if the angry sun actually had a smiley face. Ketchup chips is alright. I'm like, you know those people who are like obsessed with ketchup and put like ketchup on everything? They probably really like ketchup chips. Like, I like ketchup chips. There's nothing wrong with ketchup chips, but I don't really care for ketchup chips. I haven't had ketchup chips in like 4 years and I don't really care about that, you know? All dress, though, are insanely good. Ruffled all dress are an insanely good chip. Auto scroller, 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 auto, auto, auto scroller, auto, auto, scroll, 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 scroll. When you wake up in the morning or when you wake up for the day and you're like a speedrunner, don't think about your game because you'll just jinx yourself. Don't think about it. Don't ask yourself, I wonder if I'm going to do good today. Don't think about strats. Don't hope that you're going to play well. Don't even think about it because you're just going to jinx it. Just wake up, do whatever you do, and then just go play the game. That's it. That's all you got to do. Come on, dude. It's fucking bullshit, man. Right fucking through.
So stupid,
dude. It's bullshit. It's bullshit, so we play with the simmies. The generic baby smell. To me, when it comes with babies, why do I have to get the fire flower, man? Watch, I'm gonna get the three fire flowers. The three fire books. To me, changing a baby's diaper is like not even that much of an issue. I can't handle the baby's crying. The baby's crying and the actual smell of the baby. I've smelt shit my whole life. What a surprise. How did I know? How did I know? Because this game fucking sucks. But I love this game together. Whether I talk or you talk or anyone talks, regardless, I gotta sit here and grind this baby out. I wonder if there's a way to manipulate the boom boom to just do the fly. If you could just get the flying swoop faster, then it would still be a thing. It would make Hammer Suit way better for World 8, right? It's just we have to wait for his left and right flies. Like, he's got to go five times. He does, like, one, two, three, four, and then he goes. Right? If you could just even eliminate that. In some ROM hacks, when they put a Boomerang Bro or a Hammer Brother in the level, the Hammer Brother sometimes just... when he jumps, he just falls through the map and just dies right away. If we could get, like, say, the Boomerang Bro to do that in this world or something weird like that, then that would mean we don't have to wait for the boomerang on the screen. He would just die. We would save seconds. So Mario has a set position for when he starts a level, which can be altered on the X value. I know the Tassers manipulate the X value position of the starting point to like save frames and stuff, but I've never seen the Y position manipulated. If we could utilize the damage on that turtle in that 3-8, oh my gosh. Like if you could somehow keep that speed and take the damage from that turtle, Jesus, it would be so much faster. It's hard though, it's hard to dip down, get that damage and come back up. That's it. I'm done. Done for the day. I don't understand it. I don't do a turn back. I don't do a flutter. I do that the same as everyone else, but why do I have to duck under there? Why do I have to duck under the orb? I'm done for the day. That's it.